Défenseur, à mon avis, amoindri. De nouveau avantage.
Égalité.
Étant trompé d'un avantage tout à l'heure et regardant mes notes avec Paul Edens, cinquième avantage pour Manuel Orantes. Quelques centimètres près, c'est Orantes qui égalise à 5 jeux partout. Le public, inutile de vous le dire, est enchanté. Il est très rare d'assister à une finale de cette qualité. En général, ce sont les matchs comptant pour les quarts, voire même pour les huitièmes de finale, qui sont généralement les plus spectaculaires. Et cette année, grâce à cette finale 100% européenne, nous assistons à un tennis magnifique. Borg au service, 5 jeux partout, deuxième manche. Borg qui a perdu le premier set, 6 jeux à 2. C'est pas déconcentré, contrairement à ce que je craignais pour lui tout à l'heure.
Balle.
Orantes qui continue de bien jouer.
Deux balles. Ramassez la balle.
Sur le service de Borg. Borg qui me paraît, depuis 5 minutes, un peu fatigué. On le serait à moins. Voyez-le. Le ressort, si je puis dire, du petit Borg. Il était, effectivement, il accuse là depuis quelque temps un moment de fatigue, il est pourtant monté à la volée, il a voulu conjurer le mauvais sort qui s'acharne contre lui par la grâce d'un Orantes qui joue magnifiquement bien. Il fait très très peu de points perdants. Tout à l'heure, il est
so what an extraordinary thing after an hour and a half of play, a moment ago, Orantes 3 set points down in this second set. He saves it after the tremendous argument about the decision. And here he is, a love game to break the serve, now leads 6-5.
And Dan, so much is happening, but when you think that a few games ago we were talking about Manuel Orantes, maybe he might crack, whether he was nervous, and he played out that 5-4 game. His temperament was absolutely superb because he'd had a tremendous shock virtually seeing himself in a commanding position, losing it all. Then they had a long argument, and I've never seen him. He's a wonderful sportsman, Arantes. He never argues about line decisions, so he must have been absolutely churned up inside, and somehow then he managed to win that game and then played a very good game. And once again, Dan, Borg looks very tired, as he did in the early part of this set.
Quickly to refer to the disputed point. See, this is one of the troubles. Earlier in the match, Borg had disputed a point, and after some moments it was changed. And so Arantes felt that he had every right, I think, to dispute the call there. And so once you give way to a player when a call has been made, you're liable to this sort of thing. But let's get on with the match. The score is Arantes leading 6-5 in the second set, having won the first in this best of five-set French final. So, of course, if Borg wins this game, we're in for a tiebreak. They're having the tiebreak at 6-6. Tiebreak at 6-6 in the first four sets, but the final set played to an orthodox finish. All. That's very rare. We're almost within, two or three minutes of the previous pair bounce, we have another one here. Very, very rare indeed on this immaculate hard court to get two bad bounces like that so soon after each other. Score is 15-30. Ooh, I say, what a bad one. What a glorious shot. Well, each player has flashed out a wonderful shot here and there, surprising everybody, the crowd and the opponent. And that backhand for the Spaniard makes it 30-40.
Borg breaks back, 6-6, and we come to the tie break. The best of 12 points, the first player to 7 by a margin of 2 clear points. Borg will serve one serve, and then from then on, 2 serves each. On the line. On the line. So One love to Arantes. The best of 12 points, but if they get to 6-all, they must have a margin of 2 clear points. And the game being held up at the moment because Borg, out of the picture, wishes to wipe his racket handle, and once or twice he has asked the umpire to hurry Arantes on. 6-all, but in the tiebreak, one love to Arantes. Arantes now serving twice. Let first serve. Two more. Two love to Arantes, slightly bad bounce, very patient rally, and a good approach shot. It's tough to play these tie breaks on slow clay courts. Two love to Arantes. Just out, ball called out, 2-1 to Arantes, just past the sideline. The ball, 2-1, and Borg to serve. 2-1 for Arantes, and Borg to serve to the left-hand court. To all, one more point, one more service for Borg. On the line, 3-2 Arantes. Borg disturbed by that ball which bounced right on the line and shot through for a winner. Three, two, Arantes. Three all, after 6 points in the tiebreak, they change ends. And like this second set, this tiebreak has been just as closely contested. I must say that when Arantes got off to a two-love lead in the tiebreak, and if you get an early lead, it's a tremendous moral advantage. It looked as though he might run away with it. But once again, Borg comes back. So three all, the best two seven, best of 12 points. The first 2-7 by a margin of 2 clear points. Arantes serving. Four-three. Borg, the first time that Borg has led in this tiebreak situation. Borg serving. Through the net.
4 all.
Quite a tired looking shot by Borg. For Arantes, and once again Arantes goes get the towel, and Borg really is getting a little bit upset. He's certainly taking time, and in actual fact changed his racket, but the score is 5-4 to Arantes. And Arantes serving. A bad bounce, 6-4 to Arantes with one more serve to go. That makes two set points for a 2-set-to-love lead. That's it, just out. So 2 sets to love for Arantes, 6-2, 7-6, 7-4 in the tiebreaker. And really, it doesn't look as though Borg can come back now.
So after a very, very eventful second set, with Arantes leading at one time 4-1 and a set up, 6-2, the first set, it looked for all the world as though Arantes was going to run away with the match. Then we had that astonishing change, 4 games in a row to Borg with breaks of service to give him a 5-4 lead. And then we had the difficult situation about the decision, and now we've had the tiebreaker, and the Spanish player eventually coming home 7-6 in the second set, 7-4 in the tiebreak. So in this best of 5 set French final, it looks odds on, of course, on Arantes. But we know that this Swedish boy, only 18 years of age, is a tremendous fighter, and he has a temperament that is absolutely beyond question one of the best in the game.
And Dan, his opponent of today, Borg's opponent Arantes, has really held his temperament wonderfully well together, because when he lost his lead in that set and all the tough game when he had 3 set points against him at 4-5, he really was terribly solid. And Borg is quite upset at the moment that Arantes is taking his time. It's very humid here, and Arantes, as you've said, is having a lot of trouble holding his racket. And Borg is upset. He's asked the umpire once or twice to get Arantes to hurry on with the game. And Arantes is waiting to play, but Borg is underlining his point and saying, well, if he can take his time, so can I. And I think this is where you are right, that a central umpire must be firm right from the start. This is where things are so good at Wimbledon, is that the umpire takes control and keeps control. Because if it's good enough for one player, why shouldn't it be good for the other player? So 2 sets to love. For Arantes, as Borg goes back to receive serve at love all in the third set.
So Arantes serving, third set. Thank you.
begin.
Well, that's only the third double four to this long match. Two to Arantes. Well, he's had a very good run, really, Arantes. That was rather a loose one. Perhaps a lot of lack of concentration there. This opening game of the third set, he's leading two sets to love. Egalité, juice. Is Borg, but Borg gave Arantes a chance there with a, in the middle of that volleying rally, gave him a chance with a half-court volley that had nothing behind it at all. They've been on court 10 minutes short of 2 hours, and a very, very destructive lob there on this very, very sticky day here in Paris. A day that's beginning to sap the stamina of both men a little, I think. So an early break in this third set to Borg. Two sets to love down, the Swedish boy.
Dan Arant is just collecting just one more towel. One starts to think that can Borg come back from this position? He never gives up. He's a tremendous fighter. He's usually very strong, very physically strong. The disappointment of losing that second set must have been really vast, and the relief to Arantes of winning the second set really probably will make quite a bit of difference. The thing is that if Arantes is too relieved at winning that second set, he might start to relax at the beginning of the of this third set, and if Borg can get ahead, 2 or 3 love ahead, and then they can go in for the 10-minute break, because they have a break after the third set, and that on here on all the matches on the continent, and that break often lasts 20 minutes, 25 minutes, and then of course by the time they've had a shower, they're much, much fresher, and they come out onto court again for the fourth set, and it's a whole new match, and all sorts of things can happen then. Just listening to the umpire then, he's obviously had instructions to control the players and push them to change around a bit quicker. He was telling them that they'd had more than 1 minute and they better move on. But it's 2 sets to love to Arantes, 1 love in the third set to Borg, and Borg serving.
Out.
40-15.
So that rather fortunate net cord on Borg's part gives the Swedish boy a 2-sets-to-love lead in this third set. 2 sets to love. Sorry, 2 games to love, I mean in the third set. Dirty Love. Severe drop volley that had to be picked up if possible by the Spaniard, but really much chance. It's 30 all.
Goodbye.
Left first service. Really rather wild and under pressure by Arantes there. Deuce. Love to Borg and Deuce, third set. Egalite, Deuce, and a very fine two-hander from Borg, quick to counter-attack the quite reasonable length approach shot of Arantes. So Borg leads by 3-0 in the third set, 2 breaks to serve, and it could well be that they will finish this set at 2-1 to Arantes, and then they'll go in for the interval, and Jack Dorfman, the umpire, has just called new balls.
Dan, I was just saying earlier that I wondered whether the relief of winning that very close second set was going to react on Arantes, and I certainly think it has done. He's got a bit sort of edgy. He's missed quite a lot of shots. He's relaxed. The zest has gone out of his game, and Borg is really, who looked so tired in the start of the second set when he went to 1-4 down and then suddenly recovered. He seems to be getting stronger as the match goes on. He's moving better. Very definitely, the stiffness is out of his limbs, he's attacking more, and he's a tremendous fighter, and of course he wins so many matches from these bad positions that anything can happen with him. And the best thing that's happened so far today is that he's got to a 3-love lead in this third set, serving with new balls.
They've been on court exactly 2 hours. a very heavy service indeed from Borg there, of perfect length. Four love to Borg in the third set, two sets to love to Arantes. One feels perhaps the Spaniard may decide to let this set go. We shall see. Score is 30-15, lovely cat and mouse stuff there with the angled drop shots. So five games to love to Borg in the third set, first two sets to Arantes, and surely there won't be any possibility, I wouldn't think, of this man in your picture now, Arantes, fighting back to try and hold the third set.
I don't know about you, Dan, but I've got the impression right from 3-love that he decided that he was going to let this third set go. I can't quite understand why he's doing it, because he's not tired, he's tremendously fit, Manuel is, and he doesn't take a great deal out of himself in his game, and I should have thought that really all the points of the match that he got to keep on working Borg as hard as possible, because Borg, as we've said before, has had the tougher passage through the tournament. He's played 2 5 setters and a very tough 4 setter, whereas Manuel Arantes has only lost 2 sets to get to the final, and he must, I would have thought, get as much energy used by Borg as possible. But Borg serving 5-love, third set.
Yeah.
30-15.
Down.
40-15 and two set points for Borg. So after 2 hours and 5 minutes, of play, the score is to Borg that third set 6-love, but he lost the first two sets 6-2, 7-6, and the tiebreak score was 7-4. So Arendt is in the lead as they go in for what is supposed to be a 10-minute interval, and it's generally reckoned that it's 10 minutes from the time they get into the dressing room until the time they come out. So it could well be a good 15-minute break at least before they resume play. But both of those men must surely be looking forward to getting under a tepid shower and possibly having a quick, having their calves, probably calf muscles rubbed down by the masseur. And here we see the crowd around the centre court just having a good old stretch. They've been sitting here since well before 2 o'clock, most of them. Most of them have come in as the ladies' single was taking place. But it's a very sultry day here. We've had fitful sunshine, very warm when the sun was shining, but very sultry, and a very, very stamina-sapping day indeed for everybody.
Voyez la qualité des échanges.
30-15.
Borg au service. Suivant ce deuxième jeu, Borg ayant déjà pris le service d'Orantes dans la quatrième manche. Pleine ligne, on ne reste pas d'accord.
Voulez-vous voir la passe? Ne sifflez pas, laissez l'arbitre prendre sa décision.
C'est la troisième fois qu'il y a un tel incident.
La balle touche et merci, 40.
Mais cette finale est très très bien arbitrée par le juge de chaise, Jacques Dorfman, qui a une grande habitude. Le match important.
La balle est jugée, 40.
Je ne pense pas qu'il revienne sur cette décision.